Chapter 13 Information to the Police and Their Powers to Investigate 173 Information in Cognizable Cases 1. Every information relating to the commission of a cognizable offence, irrespective of the area where the offence is committed, may be given orally or by electronic communication to an officer in charge of a police station, and if given orally, it shall be reduced to writing by him or under his direction, and be read over to the informant, and every such information, whether given in writing or reduced to writing as aforesaid, shall be signed by the person giving it. By electronic communication, it shall be taken on record by him on being signed within 3 days by the person giving it. And the substance thereof shall be entered in a book to be kept by such officer in such form as the state government may by rules prescribe in this behalf. Provided that if the information is given by the woman against whom an offence under Section 64, Section 65, Section 66, Section 67, Section 68, Section 69, Section 70, Section 71, Section 74, Section 75, Section 76, Section 77, Section 78, Section 79 or Section 124 of the Bhartiya Nyaya Sahita, 2023 is alleged to have been committed or attempted, then such information shall be recorded by a woman police officer or any woman officer. Provided further that in the event that the person against whom an offence under Section 64, Section 65, Section 66, Section 67, Section 68, Section 69, Section 70, Section 71, Section 74, Section 75, Section 76, Section 77, Section 78, Section 79 or Section 124 of the Bhartiya Nyaya Sahita, 2023 is alleged to have been committed or attempted, is temporarily or permanently mentally or physically disabled, then such information shall be recorded by a police officer at the residence of the person seeking to report such offence or at a convenient place of such person's choice, in the presence of an interpreter or a special educator, as the case may be. B. The recording of such information shall be videographed. C. The police officer shall get the statement of the person recorded by a magistrate under clause A of subsection 6 of section 183 as soon as possible. 2. A copy of the information as recorded under subsection 1 shall be given forthwith, free of cost, to the informant or the victim. 3. Without prejudice to the provisions contained in Section 175, on receipt of information relating to the commission of any cognizable offence, which is made punishable for 3 years or more but less than 7 years, the officer in charge of the police station may, with the prior permission from an officer not below the rank of deputy superintendent of police, considering the nature and gravity of the offence, proceed to conduct preliminary inquiry to ascertain whether there exists a prima facie case for proceeding in the matter within a period of 14 days, or proceed with investigation when there exists a prima facie case. 4. Any person aggrieved by a refusal on the part of an officer in charge of a police station to record the information referred to in subsection 1 may send the substance of such information in writing and by post to the superintendent of police concerned who, if satisfied that such information discloses the commission of a cognizable offence, shall either investigate the case himself or direct an investigation to be made by any police officer subordinate to him, in the manner provided by this Sahita. And such officer shall have all the powers of an officer in charge of the police station in relation to that offence, failing which such aggrieved person may make an application to the magistrate. 174. Information as to non-cognizable cases and investigation of such cases. 1. When information is given to an officer in charge of a police station of the commission within the limits of such station of a non-cognizable offence, he shall enter or cause to be entered the substance of the information in a book to be kept by such officer in such form as the state government may by rules prescribe in this behalf. And, I, refer the informant to the magistrate. E, forward the daily diary report of all such cases fortnightly to the magistrate. 2. No police officer shall investigate a non-cognizable case without the order of a magistrate having power to try such case or commit the case for trial. 3. Any police officer receiving such order may exercise the same powers in respect of the investigation, except the power to arrest without warrant, as an officer in charge of a police station may exercise in a cognizable case. 4. Where a case relates to two or more offences of which at least one is cognizable, the case shall be deemed to be a cognizable case, notwithstanding that the other offences are non-cognizable. 175. Police officers' power to investigate cognizable case. 1. Any officer in charge of a police station may, without the order of a magistrate, investigate any cognizable case which a court having jurisdiction over the local area within the limits of such station would have power to inquire into or try under the provisions of Chapter 14. Provided that, considering the nature and gravity of the offence, the superintendent of police may require the deputy superintendent of police to investigate the case. 2. No proceeding of a police officer in any such case shall at any stage be called in question on the ground that the case was one which such officer was not empowered under this section to investigate. 3. Any magistrate empowered under Section 210 may, after considering the application supported by an affidavit made under subsection 4 of Section 173, and after making such inquiry as he thinks necessary and submission made in this regard by the police officer, order such an investigation as above mentioned. 4. Any magistrate empowered under Section 210 may, upon receiving a complaint against a public servant arising in course of the discharge of his official duties, order investigation, subject to a. receiving a report containing facts and circumstances of the incident from the officer superior to him, and b. after consideration of the assertions made by the public servant as to the situation that led to the incident so alleged. 176. Procedure for investigation. 1. If, From information received or otherwise, an officer in charge of a police station has reason to suspect the commission of an offence which he is empowered under Section 175 to investigate. He shall forthwith send a report of the same to a magistrate empowered to take cognizance of such offence upon a police report and shall proceed in person. Or shall depute one of his subordinate officers not being below such rank as the state government may, by general or special order, prescribe in this behalf, to proceed, to the spot. To investigate the facts and circumstances of the case, and, if necessary, to take measures for the discovery and arrest of the offender. Provided that A. when information as to the commission of any such offence is given against any person by name and the case is not of a serious nature, the officer in charge of a police station need not proceed in person or depute a subordinate officer to make an investigation on the spot. B. If it appears to the officer in charge of a police station that there is no sufficient ground for entering on an investigation, he shall not investigate the case. Provided further that in relation to an offence of rape, the recording of statement of the victim shall be conducted at the residence of the victim or in the place of her choice and as far as practicable by a woman police officer in the presence of her parents or guardian or near relatives or social worker of the locality, and such statement may also be recorded through any audio, video, electronic means including mobile phone. 2. In each of the cases mentioned in clauses A and B of the first proviso to subsection 1, the officer in charge of the police station shall state in his report the reasons for not fully complying with the requirements of that subsection by him, and forward the daily diary report fortnightly to the magistrate, and in the case mentioned in clause B of the said proviso, the officer shall also forthwith notify to the informant, if any, in such manner as may be prescribed by rules made by the state government. 3. On receipt of every information relating to the commission of an offence which is made punishable for 7 years or more, the officer in charge of a police station shall, from such date as may be notified within a period of 5 years by the state government in this regard, cause the forensic expert to visit the crime scene to collect forensic evidence in the offence, and also cause videography of the process on mobile phone or any other electronic device. Provided that where forensic facility is not available in respect of any such offence, the state government shall, until the facility in respect of that matter is developed or made in the state, notify the utilization of such facility of any other state. 177. Report how submitted. 1. Every report sent to a magistrate under Section 176 shall, if the state government so directs, be submitted through such superior officer of police as the state government, by general or special order, appoints in that behalf. 2. Such superior officer may give such instructions to the officer in charge of the police station as he thinks fit, and shall, after recording such instructions on such report, transmit the same without delay to the magistrate. 178. Power to hold investigation or preliminary inquiry. The magistrate, on receiving a report under Section 176, may direct an investigation, or, if he thinks fit, at once proceed, or depute any magistrate subordinate to him to proceed. To hold a preliminary inquiry into, or otherwise to dispose of, the case in the manner provided in this Sahita. 179. Police officer's power to require attendance of witnesses. 1. Any police officer making an investigation under this chapter may, by order in writing, require the attendance before himself of any person being within the limits of his own or any adjoining station who, from the information given or otherwise, appears to be acquainted with the facts and circumstances of the case, and such person shall attend as so required. Provided that no male person under the age of 15 years or above the age of 60 years, or a woman or a mentally or physically disabled person or a person with acute illness shall be required to attend at any place other than the place in which such person resides. Provided further that if such person is willing to attend at the police station, such person may be permitted so to do. 2. The state government may, by rules made in this behalf, provide for the payment by the police officer of the reasonable expenses of every person attending under subsection 1, at any place other than his residence. 180. Examination of witnesses by police. 1. Any police officer making an investigation under this chapter, or any police officer not below such rank as the state government may, by general or special order, prescribe in this behalf, acting on the requisition of such officer, may examine orally any person supposed to be acquainted with the facts and circumstances of the case. 2. Such person shall be bound to answer truly all questions relating to such case put to him by such officer, other than questions the answers to which would have a tendency to expose him to a criminal charge or to a penalty or forfeiture. 3. The police officer may reduce into writing any statement made to him in the course of an examination under this section, and if he does so, he shall make a separate and true record of the statement of each such person whose statement he records, provided that statement made under this subsection may also be recorded by audio-video electronic means. Provided further that the statement of a woman against whom an offence under Section 64, Section 65, Section 66, Section 67, Section 68, Section 69, Section 70, Section 71, Section 74, Section 75, Section 76, Section 77, Section 78, Section 79 or Section 124 of the Bhartiya Nyaya Sahita, 2023 is alleged to have been committed or attempted. 181. Statements to police and use thereof. 1. No statement made by any person to a police officer in the course of an investigation under this chapter shall, if reduced to writing, be signed by the person making it, nor shall any such statement or any record thereof, whether in a police diary or otherwise, or any part of such statement or record, be used for any purpose, save as hereinafter provided, at any inquiry or trial in respect of any offence under investigation at the time when such statement was made, provided that when any witness is called for the prosecution in such inquiry or trial whose statement has been reduced into writing as aforesaid, any part of his statement, if duly proved, may be used by the accused, and with the permission of the court, by the prosecution, to contradict such witness in the manner provided by Section 148 of the Bhartiya Sakshya Adhiniyam, 2023. And when any part of such statement is so used, any part thereof may also be used in the re-examination of such witness. But for the purpose only of explaining any matter referred to in his cross-examination. 2. Nothing in this section shall be deemed to apply to any statement falling within the provisions of Clause A of Section 26 of the Bhartiya Sakshya Adhiniyam, 2023. Or to affect the provisions of the proviso to subsection 2 of section 23 of that adhiniyam, shall be recorded by a woman police officer or any woman officer. Explanation dash. An omission to state a fact or circumstance in the statement referred to in subsection 1 may amount to contradiction if the same appears to be significant and otherwise relevant having regard to the context in which such omission occurs and whether any omission amounts to a contradiction in the particular context shall be a question of fact. 182. No inducement to be offered. 1. No police officer or other person in authority shall offer or make, or cause to be offered or made, any such inducement. Threat or promise as is mentioned in Section 22 of the Bhartiya Sakshya Adhiniyam, 2023. 2. But no police officer or other person shall prevent, by any caution or otherwise, any person from making in the course of any investigation under this chapter any statement which he may be disposed to make of his own free will, provided that nothing in this subsection shall affect the provisions of subsection 4 of section 183. 183. Recording of confessions and statements. 1. Any magistrate of the district in which the information about commission of any offence has been registered may, whether or not he has jurisdiction in the case, record any confession or statement made to him in the course of an investigation under this chapter or under any other law for the time being in force, or at any time afterwards but before the commencement of the inquiry or trial, provided that any confession or statement made under this subsection may also be recorded by audio-video electronic means in the presence of the advocate of the person accused of an offence. Provided further that no confession shall be recorded by a police officer on whom any power of a magistrate has been conferred under any law for the time being in force. 2. The magistrate shall, before recording any such confession, explain to the person making it that he is not bound to make a confession and that, if he does so, it may be used as evidence against him, and the magistrate shall not record any such confession unless, upon questioning the person making it, he has reason to believe that it is being made voluntarily. 3. If at any time before the confession is recorded, the person appearing before the magistrate states that he is not willing to make the confession, the magistrate shall not authorize the detention of such person in police custody. 4. Any such confession shall be recorded in the manner provided in Section 316 for recording the examination of an accused person and shall be signed by the person making the confession. And the magistrate shall make a memorandum at the foot of such record to the following effect. I have explained to, name, that he is not bound to make a confession and that, if he does so, any confession he may make may be used as evidence against him, and I believe that this confession was voluntarily made. It was taken in my presence and hearing, and was read over to the person making it and admitted by him to be correct, and it contains a full and true account of the statement made by him. 5. Any statement, other than a confession, made under subsection 1, shall be recorded in such manner hereinafter provided for the recording of evidence as is, in the opinion of the magistrate, best fitted to the circumstances of the case, and the magistrate shall have power to administer oath to the person whose statement is so recorded. 6. A. In cases punishable under Section 64, Section 65, Section 66, Section 67, Section 68, Section 69, Section 70, Section 71, Section 74, Section 75, Section 76, Section 77, Section 78, Section 79 or Section 124 of the Bhartiya Nyaya Sanhita, 2023. The magistrate shall record the statement of the person against whom such offence has been committed in the manner specified in subsection 5. As soon as the commission of the offence is brought to the notice of the police, provided that such statement shall, as far as practicable, be recorded by a woman magistrate and in her absence by a male magistrate in the presence of a woman. Provided further that in cases relating to the offences punishable with imprisonment for 10 years or more or with imprisonment for life or with death, the magistrate shall record the statement of the witness brought before him by the police officer. Provided also that if the person making the statement is temporarily or permanently, mentally or physically disabled, the magistrate shall take the assistance of an interpreter or a special educator in recording the statement. Provided also that if the person making the statement is temporarily or permanently, mentally or physically disabled, the statement made by the person with the assistance of an interpreter or a special educator shall be recorded through audio-video electronic means, preferably by mobile phone. B. A statement recorded under clause A of a person who is temporarily or permanently, mentally or physically disabled shall be considered a statement in lieu of examination in chief, as specified in Section 142 of the Bhartiya Sakshya Adhinayam, 2023, such that the maker of the statement can be cross-examined on such statement, without the need for recording the same at the time of trial. 7. The magistrate recording a confession or statement under this section shall forward it to the magistrate by whom the case is to be inquired into or tried. 184. Medical examination of victim of rape. 1. Where, during the stage when an offence of committing rape or attempt to commit rape is under investigation, It is proposed to get the person of the woman with whom rape is alleged or attempted to have been committed or attempted, examined by a medical expert. Such examination shall be conducted by a registered medical practitioner employed in a hospital run by the government or a local authority and in the absence of such a practitioner, by any other registered medical practitioner, with the consent of such woman or of a person competent to give such consent on her behalf, and such woman shall be sent to such registered medical practitioner within 24 hours from the time of receiving the information relating to the commission of such offence. 2. The registered medical practitioner to whom such woman is sent shall, without delay, examine her person and prepare a report of his examination giving the following particulars, namely: I. The name and address of the woman and of the person by whom she was brought. E. The age of the woman. E. The description of material taken from the person of the woman for DNA profiling. IV. Marks of injury, if any, on the person of the woman. V. General mental condition of the woman, and V. Other material particulars in reasonable detail. 3. The report shall state precisely the reasons for each conclusion arrived at. 4. The report shall specifically record that the consent of the woman or of the person competent to give such consent on her behalf to such examination had been obtained. 5. The exact time of commencement and completion of the examination shall also be noted in the report. 6. The registered medical practitioner shall, within a period of 7 days, forward the report to the investigating officer, who shall forward it to the magistrate referred to in section 193 as part of the documents referred to in clause a of subsection 6 of that section. 7. Nothing in this section shall be construed as rendering lawful any examination without the consent of the woman or of any person competent to give such consent on her behalf. Explanation. For the purposes of this section, examination and registered medical practitioner shall have the same meanings as respectively assigned to them in section 51. 185. Search by police officer. 1. Whenever an officer in charge of a police station or a police officer making an investigation has reasonable grounds for believing that anything necessary for the purposes of an investigation into any offence which he is authorized to investigate may be found in any place within the limits of the police station of which he is in charge or to which he is attached, and that such thing cannot in his opinion be otherwise obtained without undue delay, such officer may, after recording in writing the grounds of his belief in the case diary and specifying in such writing, so far as possible, the thing for which search is to be made, search or cause search to be made for such thing in any place within the limits of such station. 2. A police officer proceeding under subsection 1 shall, if practicable, conduct the search in person, provided that the search conducted under this section shall be recorded through audio-video electronic means, preferably by mobile phone. 3. If he is unable to conduct the search in person, and there is no other person competent to make the search present at the time, he may, after recording in writing his reasons for so doing, require any officer subordinate to him to make the search, and he shall deliver to such subordinate officer an order in writing, specifying the place to be searched, and so far as possible, the thing for which search is to be made, and such subordinate officer may thereupon search for such thing in such place. 4. The provisions of this Sanhita as to search warrants and the general provisions as to searches contained in section 103 shall, so far as may be, apply to a search made under this section. 5. Copies of any record made under subsection 1 or subsection 3 shall forthwith, but not later than 48 hours, be sent to the nearest magistrate empowered to take cognizance of the offence, and the owner or occupier of the place searched shall, on application, be furnished, free of cost, with the copy of the same by the magistrate. 186. When officer in charge of police station may require another to issue search warrant. 1. An officer in charge of a police station or a police officer not being below the rank of sub-inspector making an investigation may require an officer in charge of another police station, whether in the same or a different district, to cause a search to be made in any place, in any case in which the former officer might cause such search to be made, within the limits of his own station. 2. Such officer, on being so required, shall proceed according to the provisions of section 185, and shall forward the thing found, if any, to the officer at whose request the search was made. 3. Whenever there is reason to believe that the delay occasioned by requiring an officer in charge of another police station to cause a search to be made under subsection 1 might result in evidence of the commission of an offence being concealed or destroyed, it shall be lawful for an officer in charge of a police station or a police officer making any investigation under this chapter to search, or cause to be searched, any place in the limits of another police station in accordance with the provisions of section 185, as if such place were within the limits of his own police station. 4. Any officer conducting a search under subsection 3 shall forthwith send notice of the search to the officer in charge of the police station within the limits of which such place is situate, and shall also send with such notice a copy of the list, if any, prepared under section 103, and shall also send to the nearest magistrate empowered to take cognizance of the offence copies of the records referred to in subsections 1 and 3 of section 185. 5. The owner or occupier of the place searched shall, on application, be furnished free of cost with a copy of any record sent to the magistrate under subsection 4. 187. Procedure when investigation cannot be completed in 24 hours. 1. Whenever any person is arrested and detained in custody, and it appears that the investigation cannot be completed within the period of 24 hours fixed by Section 58, and there are grounds for believing that the accusation or information is well founded, the officer in charge of the police station or the police officer making the investigation, if he is not below the rank of sub-inspector, shall forthwith transmit to the nearest magistrate a copy of the entries in the diary hereinafter specified relating to the case, and shall at the same time forward the accused to such magistrate. 2. The magistrate to whom an accused person is forwarded under this section may, irrespective of whether he has or has no jurisdiction to try the case, after taking into consideration whether such person has not been released on bail or his bail has been cancelled, authorize, from time to time, the detention of the accused in such custody as such magistrate thinks fit, for a term not exceeding 15 days in the whole, or in parts, at any time during the initial 40 days or 60 days out of detention period of 60 days or 90 days, as the case may be, as provided in subsection 3. And if he has no jurisdiction to try the case or commit it for trial, and considers further detention unnecessary, he may order the accused to be forwarded to a magistrate having such jurisdiction. 3. The magistrate may authorize the detention of the accused person beyond the period of 15 days, if he is satisfied that adequate grounds exist for doing so. But no magistrate shall authorize the detention of the accused person in custody under this subsection for a total period exceeding I. 90 days, where the investigation relates to an offense punishable with death, imprisonment for life or imprisonment for a term of 10 years or more. E. 60 days, where the investigation relates to any other offence, and, on the expiry of the said period of 90 days, or 60 days, as the case may be, the accused person shall be released on bail if he is prepared to and does furnish bail. And every person released on bail under this subsection shall be deemed to be so released under the provisions of Chapter 35 for the purposes of that chapter. 4. No magistrate shall authorize detention of the accused in custody of the police under this section unless the accused is produced before him in person for the first time and subsequently every time till the accused remains in the custody of the police. But the magistrate may extend further detention in judicial custody on production of the accused either in person or through the audio-video electronic means. 5. No magistrate of the second class, not specially empowered in this behalf by the High Court, shall authorize detention in the custody of the police. Explanation I. For the avoidance of doubts, it is hereby declared that, notwithstanding the expiry of the period specified in subsection 3, the accused shall be detained in custody so long as he does not furnish bail. Explanation 2. If any question arises whether an accused person was produced before the magistrate as required under subsection 4, the production of the accused person may be proved by his signature on the order authorizing detention or by the order certified by the magistrate as to production of the accused person through the audio-video electronic means, as the case may be, provided that in case of a woman under 18 years of age, the detention shall be authorized to be in the custody of a remand home or recognized social institution. Provided further that no person shall be detained otherwise than in police station under police custody or in prison under judicial custody or a place declared as prison by the central government or the state government. 6. Notwithstanding anything contained in subsection 1 to subsection 5, The officer in charge of the police station or the police officer making the investigation. If he is not below the rank of a sub-inspector, may, where a magistrate is not available, transmit to the nearest executive magistrate, on whom the powers of a magistrate have been conferred. A copy of the entry in the diary hereinafter specified relating to the case, and shall, at the same time, forward the accused to such executive magistrate, and thereupon such executive magistrate. May, for reasons to be recorded in writing, authorize the detention of the accused person in such custody as he may think fit for a term not exceeding 7 days in the aggregate, and on the expiry of the period of detention so authorized, the accused person shall be released on bail except where an order for further detention of the accused person has been made by a magistrate competent to make such order, and where an order for such further detention is made, the period during which the accused person was detained in custody under the orders made by an executive magistrate under this subsection shall be taken into account in computing the period specified in subsection 3. Provided that before the expiry of the period aforesaid, the executive magistrate shall transmit to the nearest judicial magistrate the records of the case together with a copy of the entries in the diary relating to the case which was transmitted to him by the officer in charge of the police station or the police officer making the investigation, as the case may be. 7. A magistrate authorizing under this section detention in the custody of the police shall record his reasons for so doing. 8. Any magistrate other than the chief judicial magistrate making such order shall forward a copy of his order, with his reasons for making it, to the chief judicial magistrate. 9. If in any case triable by a magistrate is a summons case, the investigation is not concluded within a period of 6 months from the date on which the accused was arrested, the magistrate shall make an order stopping further investigation into the offence unless the officer making the investigation satisfies the magistrate that for special reasons and in the interests of justice the continuation of the investigation beyond the period of 6 months is necessary. 10. Where any order stopping further investigation into an offence has been made under subsection 9, the sessions judge may, if he is satisfied, on an application made to him or otherwise, that further investigation into the offence ought to be made, vacate the order made under subsection 9, and direct further investigation to be made into the offence subject to such directions with regard to bail and other matters as he may specify. 188. Report of investigation by subordinate police officer. When any subordinate police officer has made any investigation under this chapter, he shall report the result of such investigation to the officer in charge of the police station. 189. Release of accused when evidence deficient. If, upon an investigation under this chapter, it appears to the officer in charge of the police station that there is not sufficient evidence or reasonable ground of suspicion to justify the forwarding of the accused to a magistrate, such officer shall, if such person is in custody, release him on his executing a bond or bail bond, as such officer may direct, to appear, if and when so required, before a magistrate empowered to take cognizance of the offence on a police report, and to try the accused or commit him for trial. 190. Cases to be sent to magistrate, when evidence is sufficient. 1. If, upon an investigation under this chapter, it appears to the officer in charge of the police station that there is sufficient evidence or reasonable ground as aforesaid, such officer shall forward the accused under custody to a magistrate empowered to take cognizance of the offence upon a police report and to try the accused or commit him for trial, or if the offence is bailable and the accused is able to give security, shall take security from him for his appearance before such magistrate on a day fixed and for his attendance from day to day before such magistrate until otherwise directed, provided that if the accused is not in custody, the police officer shall take security from such person for his appearance before the magistrate, and the magistrate to whom such report is forwarded shall not refuse to accept the same on the ground that the accused is not taken in custody. 2. When the officer in charge of a police station forwards an accused person to a magistrate or takes security for his appearance before such magistrate under this section, he shall send to such magistrate any weapon or other article which it may be necessary to produce before him, and shall require the complainant, if any, and so many of the persons who appear to such officer to be acquainted with the facts and circumstances of the case as he may think necessary, to execute a bond to appear before the magistrate as thereby directed and prosecute or give evidence, as the case may be, in the matter of the charge against the accused. 3. If the court of the chief judicial magistrate is mentioned in the bond, such court shall be held to include any court to which such magistrate may refer the case for inquiry or trial, provided reasonable notice of such reference is given to such complainant or persons. 4. The officer in whose presence the bond is executed shall deliver a copy thereof to one of the persons who executed it, and shall then send to the magistrate the original with his report. 191. Complainant and witnesses not to be required to accompany police officer and not to be subject to restraint. No complainant or witness on his way to any court shall be required to accompany a police officer, or shall be subjected to unnecessary restraint or inconvenience, or required to give any security for his appearance other than his own bond, provided that if any complainant or witness refuses to attend or to execute a bond as directed in section 190, the officer in charge of the police station may forward him in custody to the magistrate, who may detain him in custody until he executes such bond, or until the hearing of the case is completed. 192. Diary of Proceedings in Investigation. 1. Every police officer making an investigation under this chapter shall day by day enter his proceedings in the investigation in a diary, setting forth the time at which the information reached him, the time at which he began and closed his investigation, the place or places visited by him, and a statement of the circumstances ascertained through his investigation. 2. The statements of witnesses recorded during the course of investigation under section 180 shall be inserted in the case diary. 3. The diary referred to in subsection 1 shall be a volume and duly paginated. 4. Any criminal court may send for the police diaries of a case under inquiry or trial in such court, and may use such diaries, not as evidence in the case, but to aid it in such inquiry or trial. 5. Neither the accused nor his agents shall be entitled to call for such diaries, nor shall he or they be entitled to see them merely because they are referred to by the court, but if they are used by the police officer who made them to refresh his memory, or if the court uses them for the purpose of contradicting such police officer. The provisions of Section 148 or Section 164, as the case may be, of the Bhartiya Sakshya Adhinayam 2023 shall apply. 193. Report of police officer on completion of investigation. 1. Every investigation under this chapter shall be completed without unnecessary delay. 2. The investigation in relation to an offence under Section 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 70, 71 of the Bhartiya Nyaya Sahita, 2023 or under Sections 4, 6. 8 or Section 10 of the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012, 32 of 2012, shall be completed within 2 months from the date on which the information was recorded by the officer in charge of the police station. 3. As soon as the investigation is completed, the officer in charge of the police station shall forward, including through electronic communication to a magistrate empowered to take cognizance of the offence on a police report, a report in the form as the state government may, by rules provide, stating a) the names of the parties, b) the nature of the information, c) the names of the persons who appear to be acquainted with the circumstances of the case, d) whether any offence appears to have been committed and, if so, by whom, a) whether the accused has been arrested, f) whether the accused has been released on his bond or bail bond, g) whether the accused has been forwarded in custody under Section 190, h) whether the report of medical examination of the woman has been attached where investigation relates to an offence under Section 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 70 or Section 71 of the Bhartiya Nyaya Sahita, 2023. I. The sequence of custody in case of electronic device. E. The police officer shall, within a period of 90 days, inform the progress of the investigation by any means including through electronic communication to the informant or the victim. E. The officer shall also communicate, in such manner as the state government may, by rules, provide, the action taken by him, to the person, if any, by whom the information relating to the commission of the offence was first given. 4. Where a superior officer of police has been appointed under Section 177, the report shall, in any case in which the state government by general or special order so directs, be submitted through that officer, and he may, pending the orders of the magistrate, direct the officer in charge of the police station to make further investigation. 5. whenever it appears from a report forwarded under this section that the accused has been released on his bond or bail bond. The magistrate shall make such order for the discharge of such bond or bail bond or otherwise as he thinks fit. 6. When such report is in respect of a case to which Section 190 applies, the police officer shall forward to the magistrate along with the report. All documents are relevant extracts thereof on which the prosecution proposes to rely other than those already sent to the magistrate during investigation. B. The statements recorded under Section 180 of all the persons whom the prosecution proposes to examine as its witnesses. 7. If the police officer is of opinion that any part of any such statement is not relevant to the subject matter of the proceedings or that its disclosure to the accused is not essential in the interests of justice and is inexpedient in the public interest, he shall indicate that part of the statement and append a note requesting the magistrate to exclude that part from the copies to be granted to the accused and stating his reasons for making such request. 8. Subject to the provisions contained in subsection 7. The police officer investigating the case shall also submit such number of copies of the police report along with other documents duly indexed to the magistrate for supply to the accused as required under Section 230. Provided that supply of report and other documents by electronic communication shall be considered as duly served. 9. Nothing in this section shall be deemed to preclude further investigation in respect of an offence after a report under subsection 3 has been forwarded to the magistrate and whereupon such investigation, the officer in charge of the police station obtains further evidence, oral or documentary, he shall forward to the magistrate a further report or reports regarding such evidence in the form as the state government may, by rules, provide. And the provisions of subsections 3 to 8 shall, as far as may be, apply in relation to such report or reports as they apply in relation to a report forwarded under subsection 3. Provided that further investigation during the trial may be conducted with the permission of the court trying the case and the same shall be completed within a period of 90 days which may be extended with the permission of the court. 194. Police to inquire and report on suicide, etc. 1. When the officer in charge of a police station or some other police officer specially empowered by the state government in that behalf receives information that a person has committed suicide or has been killed by another or by an animal or by machinery or by an accident or has died under circumstances raising a reasonable suspicion that some other person has committed an offence, he shall immediately give intimation thereof to the nearest executive magistrate empowered to hold inquests, and, unless otherwise directed by any rule made by the state government or by any general or special order of the district or subdivisional magistrate, shall proceed to the place where the body of such deceased person is, and there, in the presence of two or more respectable inhabitants of the neighborhood, shall make an investigation, and draw up a report of the apparent cause of death, describing such wounds, fractures, bruises, and other marks of injury as may be found on the body, and stating in what manner, or by what weapon or instrument, if any, such marks appear to have been inflicted. 2. The report shall be signed by such police officer and other persons, or by so many of them as concur therein, and shall be forwarded to the district magistrate or the subdivisional magistrate within 24 hours. 3. When I. The case involves suicide by a woman within 7 years of her marriage, or E. The case relates to the death of a woman within 7 years of her marriage in any circumstances raising a reasonable suspicion that some other person committed an offense in relation to such woman. Or E. The case relates to the death of a woman within 7 years of her marriage and any relative of the woman has made a request in this behalf, or IV. There is any doubt regarding the cause of death, or V. The police officer for any other reason considers it expedient so to do, he shall, subject to such rules as the state government may prescribe in this behalf, forward the body, with a view to its being examined, to the nearest civil surgeon, or other qualified medical person appointed in this behalf by the state government. If the state of the weather and the distance admit of its being so forwarded without risk of such putrefaction on the road as would render such examination useless. 4. The following magistrates are empowered to hold inquests, namely, any district magistrate or subdivisional magistrate and any other executive magistrate specially empowered in this behalf by the state government or the district magistrate. 195. Power to summon persons. 1. A police officer proceeding under section 194 may, by order in writing, summon two or more persons as aforesaid for the purpose of the said investigation. And any other person who appears to be acquainted with the facts of the case and every person so summoned shall be bound to attend and to answer truly all questions other than questions the answers to which would have a tendency to expose him to a criminal charge or to a penalty or forfeiture. Provided that no male person under the age of 15 years or above the age of 60 years, or a woman or a mentally or physically disabled person or a person with acute illness shall be required to attend at any place other than the place where such person resides. Provided further that if such person is willing to attend and answer at the police station, such person may be permitted so to do. 2. If the facts do not disclose a cognizable offence to which section 190 applies, such persons shall not be required by the police officer to attend a magistrate's court. 196. Inquiry by magistrate into cause of death. 1. When the case is of the nature referred to in clause I or clause E of subsection 3 of section 194, the nearest magistrate empowered to hold inquests shall, and in any other case mentioned in subsection 1 of section 194, any magistrate so empowered may hold an inquiry into the cause of death either instead of, or in addition to, the investigation held by the police officer, and if he does so, he shall have all the powers in conducting it which he would have in holding an inquiry into an offence. 2. Where a. any person dies or disappears, or B. rape is alleged to have been committed on any woman, while such person or woman is in the custody of the police or in any other custody authorized by the magistrate or the court. Under this Sanhita, in addition to the inquiry or investigation held by the police, an inquiry shall be held by the magistrate within whose local jurisdiction the offence has been committed. 3. The magistrate holding such an inquiry shall record the evidence taken by him in connection therewith in any manner hereinafter specified according to the circumstances of the case. 4. Whenever such magistrate considers it expedient to make an examination of the dead body of any person who has been already interred, in order to discover the cause of his death, the magistrate may cause the body to be disinterred and examined. 5. Where an inquiry is to be held under this section, the magistrate shall, wherever practicable, inform the relatives of the deceased whose names and addresses are known, and shall allow them to remain present at the inquiry. 6. The magistrate or the executive magistrate or the police officer holding an inquiry or investigation under subsection 2 shall, within 24 hours of the death of a person, forward the body with a view to its being examined to the nearest civil surgeon or other qualified medical person appointed in this behalf by the state government, unless it is not possible to do so for reasons to be recorded in writing. Explanation. In this section, the expression relative means parents, children, brothers, sisters and spouse.